Hi friends, welcome to the class of design and analysis of algorithms. In the previous lectures, we have seen what is a set, what is a disjoint set, and how to represent them. And we have seen in three different ways, three different representation. If you want, you can check in my previous video. We have seen that. Now we'll go for set operations. What are these set operations? So two main operations are there. One is union, the other one is find. So we'll see what is this union and find. So if you go for union, if two sets, if you take Si and Sj are two disjoint sets, then their union Si and union Sj is nothing but collection of all the elements. Like, let us consider, I'll explain with one example. So I have taken, of course it is with tree representation. I'll write here first S1, which is a combination of 1, 7, 8, 9. What about S2? I'll take it as 2, 5, 10. So these are the two disjoint sets and representations are, this is one tree representation, another tree representation, that is for S2. So now if I make S1 union S2, if you make set representation, we know that yes, we need to represent all the elements in those sets. Anyway, we don't find repeated element. That why? Because it is disjoint set. So like this, you can represent in sets, and this is a individual represent in tree. Now see, this is a tree representation in S1. This is a tree representation in S2. Now, what is the tree representation of S1 union S2? That we need to see. Now, how we can say, how we can connect this is, anyway, S1 union S2 is a one set. It's not two sets. One set means you need to have only one root node, not the two root nodes. So either this node should not be a root node, either this node should not be a root node. So that is what we need to see here. So how you can make is, in this rule, you can make any one node as child to the another node. Let us suppose two can be made child to the one, or one can be made child to the two. So this is what, anyway, we'll see this one in depth also. So this is simply about union. So let us suppose if I connect like this. So what happened here? This is entire tree which represents S1 union S2. So where, what is the parent of 2? Previously it is minus 1. Now it becomes, what is the parent? 1. So like this you need to represent. This is mainly you call it as union operation. Now coming to the find. Find is nothing but finding the set containing I. See, this is an indirect meaning that you need to find a root node of a particular node. Let us suppose if I ask you what is find of 5. So you need to find what is the root node of 5. That is 1. So if I ask you what is the find of 8. The root node of 8. 1. So like this you need to consider. So this is about find. Find in the sense you need to find the root node of a particular tree for a particular node. So that is what, if you take any element in this, any element, what is the find of that node? It will become the root node. Even for root node also, what is find of 1? This is also 1. So that's what we need to remember. These are the two basic operations. One is a set union, other one is a find I. Find operation. So here we have algorithms for this, and I said basically there are two operations, that is union and find. And now in union you have two types, that is simple union and weighted union, and find also, simple find and collapsing find. We'll see one by one what are these algorithms, what are these unions. Let us suppose if I take the first operation, what is that? Simple union. If I go with the simple union, how you can get the simple union means, simple union says that, what is the union I said? So you need to make any one node, make it the, you need to change the child of another node. So that's what you need to do. Let us suppose S1 union S2, I can make one is a parent of two, or else I can make two is a parent of one. Both are possible in simple union method. So in simple union method, you can make any one as root node. So that is, there is no another constraints, irrespective of how many number of elements are there, you can make like this. So my first option is, I can make like this. So I'll connect like this. This is also one representation, and or else I can do like this. This is also one more representation. So now simple algorithm, if I take algorithm simple union of I comma j, here I have given, now what is the meaning of I and j is, I means root node of the first set, j means root node of the second set. Now if I take I equals to 1, j equals to 2, now which is possible, just making parent of I equals to j, that means parent of 1 you are making it as 2, that means, so this is the answer. So parent of 1 I am making 2. Now if I take I equals to 2, j equals to 1. Now what you are doing? Parent of 2 equals to 1. Very simple method. So that is, what is this? This is a representation. You can make any one. This is about simple union. Now we'll go for simple find operation. What is this simple find operation means? Already I told you, which finds the root node of the given node. So let us take this one. What is the root node of this? I can say 5 if a node. What is the root node of 5? That is 1 only. So here if I take in this tree, what is the root node for any node? That is 2 only. So that we need to find here. So how this algorithm goes, we'll see. Okay, in general, let us take this tree. Okay, let us take this tree. Now if I take, what is the parent of I? What is the algorithm it follows is, it checks, let us suppose my node I is 5, let it be. What is the parent of I? You are getting some node. If it is not minus 1, just make your node as 2. Now what is the parent of 2? 1. It is not minus 1. Now what is the parent of 1? Now it is minus 1. Before any root node, the parent is minus 1. Now if you see this, you are getting parent of 1 is minus 1. That's why here this node you need to return simply. So if you go to the algorithm, that is also, if I take I equals to 5, while parent of 5, what is parent of 5? That is 2. So 2 is greater than 0. Yes. So now I value will become parent of 5, that is 2. Now again going to the loop. So parent of 2, which is 1. So 1 is greater than 0. Yes. So I equals to parent of 2, that is 1. Now going to the loop. Parent of 1. What is the parent of 1? Minus 1. Minus 1 anyway is not greater than, no. So comes out of the loop and returning I. What is I value? 1. So 1 will be returned. If you take here also, let us suppose if I take I equals to 8. What is the parent of 8? 1. 1 is greater than 0? Yes. So I value will become 1. So initial I'll take it as 8. 8 will become 1. Now again going to the loop. Parent of 1. What is parent of 1? 2. So 2 is greater than 0? Yes. So again going to the I value, what is this? 2. So now what is the parent of 2? Minus 1. So you need to return. What is that? You need to return 2. So this is what here it happens in simple find operation. So these are very easy, of course, very simple algorithms. Now we'll go to the third one, weighted union. So in simple union, you have a confusion that between two nodes, two root nodes, you may have a confusion that which node can be taken as root node. But whereas in weighted node, there is no confusion. Here it follows the concept of weighting rule. So what is this weighting rule is? Simply I'll tell you. You have to check the number of nodes in the first set. You have to check the number of nodes in the second set. Now which tree is having highest number of nodes, you take that tree as tree root node as root node for the resultant. Let us take for this, what are the number of nodes? 4. Here 3. Which is the highest here? So you take 1 is a root node for S1 union S2. So that's what here you need to do. So now here you can see according to the algorithm. So what happens here? So union sets with roots I and J. So now I am just tracing this. I equals to 1, J equals to 2. Like this I am tracing. Here you are taking parent of I. Actually what is the parent of 1? It is minus 1. Parent of 2? Also minus 1. But instead of taking minus 1, I am taking the count of the nodes. Why? Because it will be useful in the next line. So because we need to check the condition, that's why instead of taking minus 1, I'll take minus with total number of nodes in that, that is 4. In P of 2, I'll take total number of nodes are 3. So like this I'll take. Now coming to here, temp equals to, so minus 4 minus 3, so totally minus 7. I'll tell you why it is useful. If P of I is greater than P of J, what is the meaning here? So minus 4 is greater than minus 3. Is it true? No. Minus 4 is not greater than minus 2. That means it goes to the else part. So if this is true means I has fewer nodes. That means J will have more number of nodes. Then you need to make parent of I equals to J. Whereas J has fewer nodes means you need to make parent of J should be I. So that is only the logic we have seen here. So that's why in our example the logic is true for else part only. So J has fewer nodes, that is only, no? So I has 4 nodes, J has 3 nodes. So that condition satisfied. Now what I should do? Parent of J. So parent of J means 2 should be equals to 1. So that means parent of 2, what is it should be the parent of 2? Previously it is minus 3 I have taken, now it should be 1 only. So parent of 2 should be 1 only. So like this you need to consider. Now we can see this part. So parent of I is temp. What is the parent of 1 previously? Minus 4. But now if you take the tree, this is the entire tree where the root node is 1. Now what should be the parent of 1? It should be minus with total number of nodes. What are the total number of nodes? 4 plus 3 totally 7 you need to get. How to get that one? You can see here. Parent of 1 is equals to temp. What is the temp value? Minus 7. So now it becomes minus 7. Now you can observe the entire tree, which is S1 union S2. Now if you see the entire tree, S1 union S2, where how many number of nodes are there totally? Totally 7 nodes are there, with the root node is 1 only. So like this you need to get it. This is, you call it as weighted union. Now the last one, if you go collapsing find algorithm. So what is this collapsing find? So in find operation we are getting the root node. Even in collapsing find also you will get the root node. But what is the difference? So you can find the difference with respect to the complexity. Let us see by taking one example what is this difference. I'll take one example. So I'll take some tree I'm drawing here. Now you consider this tree. If I ask you what is, let us take one example, I need to find what is find of 7, let us suppose. So definitely the answer is 1 only, we know that. But if you go for simple find, if you go for simple find, how it checks means, first it will check what is the parent of 7, which is 6, and if it is not minus 1, again check for parent of 6, 4, if it is not minus 1, again parent of 4, that is 1. What is the parent of 1? Minus 1. Now it will return. So this is what happens if you take for simple find operations. So now how many steps it is taking? Let us take. Let us consider here. Finding parent of 7. One step. Again finding parent of 6. One step. Again here one step. Let us take 3 steps for finding find of 7. Simple find. Now if I ask you 20 times. What is find of 7? How much time it will take? 3 plus 3 plus up to 20 times, which is equals to 60. So 20 into 3, 60 it will happen. 60 units let us consider. The complexity is 60 units. Now, what happens in collapsing find is, now if I ask you what is find of 7, it will check for what is parent of 7? 6. So it will collapse the node 6. It will collapse the node 6. Next, again what it happens is, generally it will check for first finding the root node, and it will store that root node value in R. It will store the root node value in R. Anyway, root node is 1. Now in the path, whatever the nodes you are getting, for every node it makes its parent is 1. Let us suppose for this, after processing this, anyway I'll explain this. What happens is, parent of 4, 1, okay. What is the parent of 6? Not 4. It will make like this. Now 7. What is the parent of 7? It will make like this. Finally, after this collapsing find operation. So what is the advantage here is, now initially if I ask you what is find of 7, what happens is, first finding parent and collapsing this, let us suppose 2 units of time, again finding parent and collapsing, again 2 units, here 2 units totally, let us take 6 units of time. But remaining 19 times if I ask you what is find of 7, directly you will get the answer, which is 1 unit of time. So 1 unit into 19, totally 19 units, 19 plus 6 totally 25 units of time. If you compare with simple find, it is taking 60. Here it is taking less complexity. This is what here happens. So let us see how it will collapse all those things. Here you can see, if j is a node on the path from I to its root node and p of I is not equals root, anyway that is correct, then set p of j to root I. Now collapsing find of I, here I'll take I equals to 7. You need to find, yeah, r equals to what? R equals to 7, that is I means 7, while p of r means 7, parent of 7 is greater than 0. What is parent of 7? 6. So 6 is greater than 0, yes. So do r equals to parent of 7, that is 6. Now again coming to the loop, so parent of 6, is greater than 0, yes. What is parent of 6? 4. 4 is greater than 0. Now make r equals to parent of 6. Again going to the loop, parent of 4, 1. 1 is greater than 0, yes. So again r equals to 1. Now what is parent of 1? Parent of 1, because it is a root node, no, this will become minus 1. So minus 1 is not greater than, no, then it comes out of the loop. Now what is the r value? 1. Remember this point, r value is 1. You are getting the root node. Now while I is not equals to r, what is I value? 7. R value 1. See this. Now what happens? S equals to parent of I, parent of 7, which is 6. Now parent of, now you can see parent of 7, which is equals to 1. I means, that is R means 1. Why? Because previously parent of 7 is 6. Now what happens? Parent of 7 is 1. Like this it is connecting. That means it is collapsing all those things and directly it is connecting. Now I equals to what? S in the sense 6. Now again going to the loop, while 6 is not equals to 0, yes, S equals to parent of 6. What is parent of 6? 4. So P of, what is it? 6. What is P of 6? Parent of I, that is 6, equals to R, that means 1. That means parent of 6 you are making 1. Previously it is 4, now you are making 1. Now I equals to S, S means 4. Now S equals to parent of next value 4. Parent of 4 is equals to 1. So now S value is 1. Now P of, what you need to consider? 4. P of I means 4 is equals to 1. You are making parent of 4 1. And now I value is parent of, I value is S. S1 means 1. Now you can check. I value is 1. R value is 1. So comes out of the loop. Return R. What is R value? 1, which is your root node. See, collapsing is happening here, finding the root node here. That is, what is the find value you are finding here? Collapsing here happens. So this is of finding collapsing find. So especially if in exam they will ask what is the difference between find and collapsing find, you can say that there is, the answer is same, but there is a difference in the complexity. To get the less complexity, we'll go for collapsing find. Thank you.